So this is important point to understand when we are discussing about giant cells. So in our human body, we will be having two types of giant cells. One will be the physiological and one will be pathological. So now we are dividing giant cell into two broader category: physiologic giant cells, which is normally present in our human body. So physiologic is the normal type of giant cells which we normally find in our human body, and second is the pathologic, right, which is seen in pathology only. So pathologic and physiologic, so these are two type of giant cells. Physiologic giant cells, examples, examiner may ask in your exam: in bone marrow, presence of megakaryocytes. So megakaryocytes are giant cell which are seen in bone marrow, and another bone marrow physiologic giant cell will be osteoclasts. So osteoclasts are also considered as an example of giant cell. So megakaryocyte and osteoclasts are giant cell. Pathologic giant cells, there are numerous examples, right? For example, when you take the example of the Ashcroft giant cell, so Ashcroft giant cells are seen in rheumatic heart disease. So this is seen in rheumatic heart disease. So actually Ashcroft giant cell will be diagnostic of rheumatic heart disease, right? So this point we have to keep in mind. Ashcroft giant cells are diagnostic of rheumatic heart disease. This is one pathological giant cell. Another pathological giant cell is the Reed-Sternberg cells. Reed-Sternberg cells are seen in Hodgkin's lymphoma, right? So they are seen in Hodgkin's lymphoma. So this is the second type of giant cell. Third type of pathologic giant cell which I wanted to discuss here is Towton giant cell. This is the question in older All India exam: Towton's giant cells are seen in which condition? So that was the question. So remember, Towton giant cells are seen in xanthomas. So these are seen in xanthoma. So that was the right answer. Towton giant cells are seen in xanthoma. This was the question in All India exam, right? So what will be the future question? Image based question, because Towton giant cell images are very very easy to identify in your exam. Why I said very easy to identify in your exam? When you will see them like this, this is the giant cell, you will find that arrangement of nuclei is like a ring of nuclei. So now you can see, we will be seeing ring of nuclei. So what I'm showing you here, ring of nuclei. So they will be having ring of nuclei, and within the ring of nuclei you will find cytoplasm is normal or intact. Cytoplasm is normal. So within the ring of nuclei we are seeing normal cytoplasm, and outside you will be seeing foamy or clear cytoplasm. Foamy or clear cytoplasm. So that is how you have to identify. Whenever you see a ring of nuclei, and within the ring of nuclei normal cytoplasm, and outside you are seeing foamy cytoplasm, so this will be the property of Towton's giant cell which is seen in xanthoma, right? Fourth one is previous year All India question, that is called Warthin-Finkeldy giant cell. Warthin-Finkeldy giant cell. Question was, Warthin-Finkeldy giant cells are seen in which infection? And answer was measles, right? So Warthin-Finkeldy cells are seen in measles infection, and when they will be affecting the lung tissue, this will be causing measles will be causing atypical pneumonia. So what is name of this atypical pneumonia in measles? So atypical pneumonia in measles. So remember, this will be causing atypical pneumonia, and atypical pneumonia which is seen in measles are called as Het's pneumonia, right? So this point also we have to keep in mind. This is called Het's pneumonia. Examiner may ask this question in future exam also, right? So atypical pneumonia which we are seeing in measles infection, they are called as Het's pneumonia. So Warthin-Finkeldy giant cells are seen in which pneumonia? Answer should be Het's pneumonia, which is caused by measles, right? So that was the question in All India exam previous year. So how to identify Werthin-Finkeldy giant cells? Werthin-Finkeldy giant cells will be irregular. Now you can see, how are they? They are irregular giant cell, multinucleated giant cells. In this irregular giant cells, what you will notice, apart from this, you will notice they are having eosinophilic, intranuclear as well as intracytoplasmic viral inclusion. See what I am saying? Eosinophilic viral inclusions. Eosinophilic viral inclusions will be seen. So eosinophilic viral inclusions will be seen in this giant cell. Now question is, where? Inside the nucleus or inside the cytoplasm? So your answer will be, this eosinophilic viral inclusion will be present in both cytoplasm and nuclei. So cytoplasm and nucleus both will be having this eosinophilic dot like punctate viral inclusion. So this will be present inside the nucleus also, and this will be present inside the cytoplasm. So this is the perfect picture of Werthin-Finkeldy giant cells. Irregular giant cells, eosinophilic viral inclusion in nuclei, in cytoplasm, both places, right? Now we will see these giant cell. See, this is how a question will be asked in our exam, right? So this is the very characteristic picture. While seeing itself, you can make it out, this is the Towton giant cell. How we will know that? Now you can see there is a ring of nuclei. You can see this is the ring of nuclei, right? And you can see within the ring of nuclei, cytoplasm is normal. And when you are looking at the outside area, when you are looking at outside the area of the cytoplasm, you can see there is a foamy cytoplasm, right? So ring of nuclei, you can see there is a ring of nuclei. Nuclei is having normal cytoplasm, and outside there is a foamy cytoplasm. So this is a Towton giant cell. So what is this picture? This picture is Towton's giant cell. And Towton giant cells are seen in which condition? Xanthoma. So that is how question had been asked in All India exam, right? So this is how we can identify. Look at the another picture of the Towton giant cell. See, a beautiful picture which examiner may ask in future exam. If you look at this giant cell, can you see this? There is a ring of nuclei, cytoplasm is normal, and outside you can see foamy or clear cytoplasm. Same description holds here also. You can see there is also one Towton giant cell. See, look at this cell. This is also Towton giant cell. Look at this cell. Ring of nuclei, cytoplasm is normal, and outside it is foamy or clear cytoplasm. So there are numerous Towton giant cells are seen in this biopsy of the Xanthoma patient, right? Now look at this picture, which was the question in All India exam, right? Now we are looking at the picture of the lung biopsy. In this lung biopsy, you can see this is the alveolar septa. And now you can notice there is a cell, irregular appearance, and you can notice there is a nuclei. These are nuclei. And in this, we will notice that eosinophilic punctate viral inclusions are present. And same color of the viral inclusion. Remember, the same color of viral inclusion is seen here also. Seen here also, right? So we can see that both intranuclear and cytoplasmic inclusion in an irregular. You can see there is another beautiful irregular Werthin-Finkeldy giant cells. You can see this area is full of small point or pinpoint like viral inclusions, right? You can see pinpoint like viral inclusions, and similar viral inclusions are seen inside the nucleus also. So that is why I am saying it is both nuclear and cytoplasmic, and this is the Werthin-Finkeldy giant cell, right? So this is how we will identify Werthin-Finkeldy giant cells, which is seen in measles, and this pneumonia is called as atypical pneumonia, known as Het's pneumonia, right? So this is how we will understand about granulomas. So this is granuloma, which is a pattern of chronic inflammation.